The Girl in the Spider's Web is a new crime thriller movie that is kind of like a soft reboot to The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo film that was directed by David Fincher a few years ago. That film starred Daniel Craig. It starred Rooney Mara as the main two characters in the movie. And like I said, it was directed by David Fincher. This one is directed by Fede Alvarez, I believe. The cast is different, but it's still characters that exist, I guess, in the same universe as that film. You have Lisbeth Salander, played by Claire Foy. Lakeith Stanfield is also in this movie. You also have Sylvia Hoeks, and I can't even remember the guy that plays Michael Blomquist, but he does show up in the movie. By the way, as a side note, it is very easy to accidentally call her Lisbeth Salamander when you're trying to call her Lisbeth Salander, so it's a thing. I just thought I'd mention it. It was just a lot harder to get that out of my head before I started to shoot this video. So the story in this movie is Lisbeth Salander is doing her thing, you know, worldwide badass hacker. She's taking out the bad men who hurt women. She's contacted by somebody in the NSA who has access to some kind of file. This file can somehow allow one user to get access to multiple nuclear weapons around the planet. So she's hired to go find this file, but unfortunately when she tries to track down this file, she finds out that other people are after this file as well. There's this mysterious group called the Spiders that are after it, so the more she tries to find this file and figure out where it came from and why these people are after it, the deeper into the web she falls. I seriously should fire myself. I mean, it should be a crime to be this corny. What I can say about this movie, that is definitely a very good looking movie and it's competently shot and directed. It's always a big thing for me in movies. It's always something that I'm looking for. When you're looking at like these crime thriller movies that are trying to captivate you with a good story, sometimes it can take you out of the movie a little bit if a movie isn't well lit or if it doesn't have good shots or if the shots are all over the place or whatever. But this movie, I think the cinematography is pretty good. I think the direction is pretty good. Overall, I think it's a solid movie if you're just looking for the technical aspects of it. Performances in the movie are definitely workmanlike. They all really work. Claire Foy, it's kind of hard to look at her performance and not compare her to the other Lisbeth Salanders that have come before her. And to be fair, sometimes that comparison is an inevitable thing. You can't really avoid it. I don't think she really sells you on the role the way that the other ones did, but I will say that she did a good job for this movie. There are a few moments scattered throughout the film where she captures some of the badass moments that makes you really like Lisbeth Salander as a character. I just thought she was fine, and I thought that pretty much everybody else in the film was just fine. They all did their job. I do think that the musical score for this film definitely was good. I can't remember the composer of the musical score right now because I have really shitty memory, but rest assured, whoever you are out there, you did your damn thing with this movie. And if you're looking for just pure entertainment value out of a crime thriller like this, I can tell you there's definitely a few sequences that are going to stand out. There's a few well-placed and well-shot action sequences throughout the runtime that are going to keep you somewhat engaged with what's going on. Definitely some action sequences that push the boundaries on suspension of disbelief. I'm just saying there are some times in this movie where action scenes are happening and I can't tell if I'm watching a shot out of the Watch Dogs video games mixed with female James Bond. I'm just saying there are a couple of shots in this movie that you can't get away from where you're like, yep, that is female James Bond. Daniel Craig actually should be in this movie, seeing that he is James Bond. It would make more sense that way. Then again, the verdict when I walked out of the theater was just kind of meh, because overall, I think this movie is just fine. It's just fine. It's okay. Nothing about this movie really knocked my socks off or impressed me. I mean, it's a fine little crime thriller. If you compare it to some of the other films in the Girl with the Dragon Tattoo series, especially the ones directed by David Fincher, or maybe the Swedish films with Naomi Rapace as the main lead, it doesn't really hold up when you compare it to those films. Those films had a little bit more going on with them in terms of depth and in terms of complexity. This film is just trying to be a straightforward crime thriller, and that's one of the disappointing aspects of this film. It's a rated R movie that feels somehow edited down to be PG-13, but they threw in a few F-bombs, so they still kept it rated R. They definitely hint and tease at some darkness and some gritty, disturbing things in this movie, but they never really go full bore with the shit. They don't really explore it in depth, and if this movie's idea of depth is having random spiders just crawling in random frames throughout the film, well, I can really do without that, because that's pretty much just the spider winking at the camera and saying, yep, glorified spider cameo, we want all the smoke. I'll also say that the story in this film isn't really all that engaging or interesting. It was really hard for this film to really grab me and get me invested in what was going on from a narrative perspective. A lot of the story feels very lazy and unimaginative, uninspired even. Definitely a few predictable parts. There are characters that go in and out of the story, and their relevance and importance to the plot kind of varies from scene to scene. Some characters are in the movie and you're just kind of like, okay, I get and understand why you're in the movie, but I don't really get why you're in the movie. Like, if I take you away from the movie, does it hurt the movie that much? Main villain in the movie, which if you've seen the second trailer for this film, you've pretty much seen the main villain and you know everything about the main villain that you need to know. So I hope to God that you haven't seen seen that trailer. But as far as she goes in this movie, she's really not in the movie that much. She shows up during the third act of the film, and she's fine, I guess, but she really didn't stand out in my mind. Didn't really do a good enough job at establishing the backstory and the relationship and the connection between Lisbeth and this villain. So when things are happening during the third act, it just doesn't hit with the emotional impact that I think they're trying to go for. Overall, I found myself getting a little bit bored throughout the runtime. I don't have strong feelings about this movie one way or the other, so I'm going to put it where all average films on this channel go, in the Fortress of Solitude. Alright guys, those are my thoughts on A Girl in a Spider's Web, so tell me, what is your favorite adaptation of those books, or if you've read the novels, what's your favorite book? Like and subscribe to the Superfan Show, and as always, if you like what you see, tell me how you feel, and stay tuned to hear more from the Man of Steel. Peace!